student scholars in association with Goa Headmasters Association.
Hello everyone. In the last session, we have learnt regarding the respiration. There is a difference between respiration and breathing. Respiration is the process in which energy is released using the food. And breathing is just taking air in and giving out carbon dioxide. So, last time we have learnt that in the lungs, there is one balloon-like structure or balloon-like structures present in the lungs which provides the surface area for exchange of gases. So, in alveoli, oxygen is taken in, and this oxygen which is taken in, that oxygen is supplied to the heart, and this is done by blood vessel. There are three types of blood vessels present in our body. They are arteries, veins, and capillaries. Capillaries, these are the smallest blood vessels present in our body. So, from lungs, the oxygen is carried by one of the blood vessels known as the pulmonary vein. Arteries normally carry pure blood. When I say pure blood, the blood which is rich in oxygen. Veins carry impure blood, blood which is rich in carbon dioxide. So, there is one vein which will carry pure blood or oxygenated blood, the blood which is rich in oxygen. So, from lungs to the heart, oxygen is carried by the blood, and this blood is transported by blood vessel known as the pulmonary vein. So, in short, from lungs to heart, pulmonary vein transport oxygenated blood, the blood which is rich in oxygen. Now, today we are going to start with transportation in human beings. As I said regarding the blood, now what blood consists of? Blood consists of fluid medium called as the plasma, which is yellow in color. Besides this, blood consists of white blood cells or white blood corpuscles, red blood corpuscles here you can see, and platelets. They perform their functions. Now, this blood is carried by blood vessels. Blood vessels are tubes. In 9th standard, we have learned that blood is an example of connective tissue. Transportation is done by blood. Now, what is transported by blood? So, blood transport food, oxygen, salt, and waste. Plasma also performs functions. So, plasma transport carbon dioxide, nitrogenous waste, food. So, plasma transport food, carbon dioxide and nitrogenous waste in dissolved form. These red blood cells, we can see or we have noticed, jenna ami patta tenna kenna kenna ragat yela astale. So, tya vela jenna ragat yeta tenna ami rag, we have seen blood is red in color. This red color is due to pigment present in the blood, red pigment present in the blood. We call it as hemoglobin. Hemoglobin also plays very important role. When oxygen enters in our lungs, when it is carried by blood, at that time hemoglobin binds the oxygen. If oxygen is taken in, hemoglobin binds the oxygen, and as the blood flows, hemoglobin also carry that oxygen. So, red blood cells consists of or contains hemoglobin. So red blood cells, they contain hemoglobin, and hemoglobin binds the oxygen. Blood transport oxygen. White blood cells, sometimes in our body, diseases causing microorganisms enter. Diseases causing microorganisms, they are called as the pathogens, and these white blood cells, they fight against these diseases causing microorganisms. As I said earlier, that blood from the oxygenated blood from lungs, it is transported to the heart. Heart is the organ that pumps the blood. आणि हार्टाची साईज आमची मूठ बंद करून जी पळय मुठीची साईज असं त्या साईजचं आमचं हार्ट असतलो. ओके, नाव हार्ट पंप्स द ब्लड. सो हार्ट इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट ऑर्गन. वन्स अगेन, इट हेल्प्स इन ऑर इट पंप्स द ब्लड. नाव लेट अस स्टडी रिगार्डिंग द ह्युमन हार्ट. Human heart has four chambers. Before going to the chambers, I will tell you regarding this. Vena cava, as you can see the name, vena cava. Vena cava is the name of the vein. Pulmonary arteries, name of the artery, one of the arteries. Pulmonary veins is one of the veins. So human heart has four chambers. They are left atrium, left ventricle, right ventricle, and right atrium. The upper part of the heart, this part, we call it as atria. Atria is the plural, and singular is atrium. Then, lower part of the heart consists of ventricles. So left and right. I am facing you all, or this heart is facing you all. The diagram of this heart is facing you. So this side of the heart is left side, and this side of the heart is right side. So left side of the heart carry oxygenated blood, the blood which is rich in oxygen. Right side of the heart carry or consists of deoxygenated blood, the blood which is rich in carbon dioxide. So from the lungs, oxygenated blood enters in the heart here in left atrium. And few minutes back I told that pulmonary veins bring that blood or oxygenated blood in heart. So left atrium receives the oxygenated blood. When this left atrium receives the oxygenated blood, at that time left atrium will be in relaxed position. After some time, left atrium will contract, and when this left atrium contracts, at that time the blood enters from left atrium in left ventricle. So when left ventricle receives the blood, at that time left atrium relaxes. After some time left atrium will contract, and because of that contraction the blood will come out of the heart via aorta. Aorta is name of the artery. And when this blood comes out of the heart, this is oxygenated blood, it comes at very high pressure. Left ventricle or ventricles have thick muscular walls. So ventricles have to pump blood out of the heart or away from heart. That is why they have thick muscular walls. So from this aorta, the blood will be supplied to various parts of our body. The diagram that we are looking at is the schematic sectional view of the human heart. Coming back to the deoxygenated blood. So deoxygenated blood will be carried by vena cava. These are nothing but veins from different parts of our body. And that deoxygenated blood will enter here in left, in right atrium. So this deoxygenated blood comes from the lower part of our body, and this deoxygenated blood comes from the upper part of our body. So blood which is rich in carbon dioxide enters in the right atrium. When right atrium collects the blood, at that time right atrium will be in relaxed position. After some time right atrium will contract, and when right atrium will contract, the blood will enter in the right ventricle. When right ventricle receives the blood, at that time right ventricle will be in relaxed position. After some time right ventricle will contract, and due to that the blood again comes out of heart. And this deoxygenated blood, or the blood which is rich in carbon dioxide, this blood is transferred to the lungs through this pulmonary arteries. So pulmonary artery carry deoxygenated blood, and pulmonary veins carry oxygenated blood. Pulmonary arteries carry deoxygenated blood from heart to lungs, and pulmonary veins carry oxygenated blood from lungs to heart. And when blood comes out of the heart, it comes out with high pressure. Now left side of the heart consists of pure blood, right side of the heart carry impure blood. I think I have told this earlier. The left and right side of the heart is divided by one wall. We call this dividing wall as septum. Now human heart has four chambers, 1, 2, 3 and 4, or we can consider 1, 2, 3 and 4. This four chambered heart, which is present in our body, this prevents the, or left hand side and right hand side of the heart, this prevents the mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. Okay. So we have four chambered heart to prevent the mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. Now, so what happens to the oxygenated blood? Before that, we can see here here valves are present. Ansar valvasta. These valves play very important role. आमी सायकलीच्या टायरान वारो भरता. सो सायकलीच्या टायरान ट्यूब आसता आनी ट्यूबाक वाल्व आसता. सो वाल्व कितें करता, एकाच सायडीच्यान वारें येवपाक दिता. ओके, सेम फंक्शन इज परफॉर्म्ड हियर. वाल्व एलावज द ब्लड टू फ्लो इन ओनली वन डायरेक्शन. When blood enters from left atrium to ventricle, these valves allow the blood to come or to travel, or blood to enter or to pass in only one direction, okay, not in opposite direction. So valves play very important role. Now let us look at schematic representation of transport and exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide. I told you all that ventricles have to pump blood to different organs. That is why ventricles have thick muscular walls, thick walls, and that is passed through this aorta. So aorta will carry oxygenated blood to different parts of our body. When aorta will try to reach, when they will try to reach near the cells, at that time they become smaller, and smallest artery or the smallest blood vessels, as I said earlier, they are called as the capillaries. So the capillaries are one cell thick. This allows capillaries and cells to exchange the materials. For example, oxygen has to be absorbed, has to be given to the cells, and cells will produce carbon dioxide. So that carbon dioxide capillaries has to absorb. So through the walls of capillaries, this takes place. Oxygen is passed to the cells through the walls of capillaries, and carbon dioxide again passed from the carbon dioxide passes from the cell to the capillaries through the walls of the capillaries. Okay. So oxygenated blood reaches in different cells. Deoxygenated blood, or here carbon dioxide, if it is produced, that carbon dioxide will be again taken by the capillaries, and capillaries combine to form veins, and veins will collect deoxygenated blood from various parts of our body. Deoxygenated blood which is rich in carbon dioxide, and that blood will enter in the right atrium here. Okay, right atrium. Then this blood, deoxygenated blood, enters in the right ventricle. From this right ventricle, the blood will be carried to the lungs. And as I said here, that pulmonary artery carry deoxygenated blood. We can see here, pulmonary artery, they carry deoxygenated blood to the lungs. And during the process of, during when we were learning regarding the respiration, when we were learning regarding the breathing mechanism, lungs always consists of residual volume of air during breathing, because in the lungs exchange of gases has to take place. So carbon dioxide is given out in the lungs, oxygen is taken in, okay, from air in the lungs. So we have understood the schematic sectional view of the human heart and schematic representation of transport and exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide. Human heart, as I said earlier, we have four chambered heart. Birds have four chambered heart because we constantly require energy to maintain our body temperature. And because of this, and because of the presence of four chambered heart, we get continuous oxygen and energy will be released. As we learnt in respiration process, wherein glucose reacts with oxygen to form water, carbon dioxide, and energy is released in that case. So we constantly require energy to maintain our body temperature. Even birds also require energy to maintain their body temperature. So we cannot tolerate mixing of oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood. But there are some organisms which can tolerate mixing of oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood. So some reptiles like lizard have three chambered heart. Amphibians like frogs which are found in water and also on the land, they also have three chambered heart. They can tolerate some mixing of oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood. So in that case, energy production will be less. As you can see here, images, birds have four chambered heart like human beings, lizard, and amphibian like frog have three chambered heart. Fishes have two chambered heart. So what happens in case of fishes or fish? Fishes, they take the oxygen which is dissolved in water, and they have the organ called as the gills. and gills helps in taking oxygen in. So, in human beings, oxygen is taken in at the lungs, and from the lungs it is transported to the heart, and from heart oxygen is supplied to all the parts. In case of fishes, oxygen is taken in the gills, and from the gills the oxygen is supplied with the help of blood vessels to different parts of the fish. So there is a difference here. In case of fishes, oxygen pahili gilsank eta ani gilsachan sagle parts ani vayta, pun oxygen gilsachan hatakade vasna pahili. Pun in human beings oxygen lungsakadlan hatak eta ani hatakadlan saglan pavayta, blood pavpache kaam karte. When all the parts receives the oxygen in case of fishes, some part may produce carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide will be carried by the blood, and that carbon dioxide reaches in the heart of fish, and then that carbon dioxide will be given out. So in case of fishes, the blood enters in the heart only once. But in case of human beings, as we have seen in previous diagram, this diagram, the blood enters in the heart twice during the entire cycle. This is for the first time when the blood enters in the heart, and this is the second time blood enters in the heart. So we call such circulation wherein the blood enters in the heart twice during, or blood goes through the heart twice during each cycle, call such circulation as double circulation. So double circulation takes place in human beings. Double circulation also takes place in some vertebrates. These organisms like lizard, frog, they can tolerate some mixing of oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood. I think we have covered this. While observing the diagram of blood, we, or image of blood, we have seen platelets. Platelets plays very important role. Kenna kenna ami khelta astana patta ani ragat pavta he ragat continuously vavat ravna ek stage ashi etli, okay, ki je ragat pavta te band jatle, whenever we get injury, when we are injured, then jata te band jate platelets sa khate. So platelet cells, they circulate in our body. Jashe blood circulate jata, blood and platelets asta. So platelet cells also circulate in our body. So when the blood vessel breaks, or when the wall of the blood vessel breaks, at that time the blood will try to come out of this, from this part. So what a platelet will do, platelet cells will clot the blood here. So sort of mesh, jali shi tayar jata hanga, okay, and that helps in clotting the blood, and the blood will not come out of the blood vessels. So platelet cells plays very important role. So at the point of injury, I repeat, at the point of injury, platelet cells, they plug the leakage, okay. How they plug the leakage? They form clot, okay. Next thing is regarding the lymph. Lymph is also known as the tissue fluid. Between the cells there is space, ek cell, dusra cell, अशे भरपूर सेल असतले, पण सेल्साच्या मध्ये जागा असतलो. वी कॉल द स्पेस, नाउ कन्सिडर दिस इज जस्ट एन एक्झाम्पल टू शो यू ऑल. इमॅजिन दीज आर सेल्स, ओके, अँड बिटवीन द सेल्स देर इज स्पेस. हियर वी कॅन सी हियर स्पेस. सो दिस स्पेस बिटवीन द सेल्स वी कॉल एज इंटरसेल्युलर स्पेस. वी ऑलरेडी नो द स्मॉलेस्ट ब्लड वेसल्स एज कॅपिलरीज. Capillaries, they are one cell thick, And there are walls present in capillaries, or there are walls present, or there are walls of the, or walls of the capillaries are present. So through these walls, or through the pores present in the walls of the capillaries, some amount of plasma, proteins, and blood cells enter in this intercellular space to form lymph. So, lymph consists of plasma, proteins, blood cells. If we compare lymph with plasma, plasma is yellow in color, whereas lymph is colorless. Lymph consists of less amount of proteins. Now, lymph performs two important functions. In one of the classes, we have learnt that complete digestion takes place in our small intestine. Fats gets converted into fatty acids and glycerol. We have learnt this. So, lymph, one of the functions of lymph is lymph carry absorbed fat or digested fat in small intestine. Lymph, it drains excess fluid from extracellular space. Intercellular space and extracellular space both are same. So, lymph sends or drains excess fluid from extracellular space back into the blood. So, these are the two functions performed by lymph. That is, lymph carry absorbed fat or digested fat from the small intestine, and lymph drains excess fluid from extracellular space back into the blood. Lymph is also known as tissue fluid. Now, we have completed transportation in human beings. Now, we will learn transportation in plants. So, we have completed transportation in human beings. Now, what we have learnt in this, when we learnt transportation in human beings? We learnt regarding the blood and what is present in that blood: red blood cells, white blood cells, plasma, then platelets. After that, we learnt regarding the human heart, which has four chambers. So, we have completed regarding the lymph. One more thing, very important thing. As I said earlier, that blood vessels are of three types, known as arteries, veins, and capillaries. Let us understand the difference between the arteries and veins. Okay? So, I have to show you the, let us understand the difference between the arteries and veins. Aorta is an example of artery. This is one of the arteries. So, aorta carry oxygenated blood, or aorta carry blood away from the heart to different parts of the body, as we can see here. So, aorta is an example, or is one of the arteries. So, arteries carry blood from heart to different parts of our body, whereas veins carry blood from different parts of the body back to the heart. Arteries, they have thick elastic walls. Their walls are thick. Arteries walls thick astat as compared to the walls of the veins. So, why arteries have thick walls? Because blood emerges from the heart at high pressure, and these arteries have to withstand that pressure. And because of this, arteries have thick elastic walls. So, arteries carry the blood, oxygenated blood, to different parts from the heart. Veins have thin walls. Current, when the blood flows in veins or through veins, at that time the blood is not under high pressure. So, that is why veins have thin walls. In fact, veins have valves, and we learnt the function of the valves here when we learnt regarding the human heart. So valves allows the blood to only flow in one direction. Veins have valves, whereas arteries, in arteries valves are absent. Veins have thin walls, arteries have thick walls. Arteries carry blood from heart to different parts of our body, whereas veins collect blood from different parts of our body and it is transported to the heart. Okay? So these are the points of differences between arteries and veins. Let us learn regarding transportation in plants. So in plants transportation system is slow because plants consist of many dead cells. In one of the classes we learned that plants require carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide plants take in from the air. Plants also require oxygen for respiration. Sometimes oxygen in plants acts as waste product, keep in mind. But plants, they also require oxygen for respiration to stay alive. Plants have two vascular tissues. Plants have two different tissues. Both are complex tissues which helps in transportation. The two tissues which helps in transportation in plants are xylem and phloem. Xylem transport water and minerals in plants, whereas phloem transports soluble products of photosynthesis. Let us learn now how, in what way roots absorb water from the soil. So, as we can see here roots, or there will be fine root hairs, and these root hairs, they are in contact with the soil. So they always try to take ions. As we know that plants also require minerals like phosphorus, iron, then magnesium. Root hairs, they actively take ions from the soil. When there is difference in concentration of the ions present in the roots and present in the soil, to eliminate this difference, water enters in the roots and slowly water column will rise. So this is one of the ways by which water enters in the plants. So roots absorb water from the soil. Then plants also lose water in the form of water vapor from the aerial parts, the parts which are in contact with the air, and we call this process as transpiration. So what is transpiration? The loss of water in the form of water vapor from the aerial parts of the plant, we call it as transpiration. During transpiration, plants lose water. When plants lose water in the form of water vapor, the water that is lost by the stomata, that water will be replaced by the water present in the xylem vessels of the leaves. As I said earlier, xylem helps in transportation of water in plants. Xylem consists of tracheids and vessels. So these vessels and tracheids of the xylem, of the roots, stem and leaves, they are connected to one another. That is why water can be transported from roots directly to the leaves. During the process of transpiration also helps the plants to absorb water. So when plants lose water, pressure will be created here, and that pressure will try to absorb water from the from the soil. So roots will try to absorb, or roots will absorb the water from the soil, and that water will be taken in and will be transported by the xylem. So transpiration, it helps the plants, this process helps the plant. Transpiration helps the plant in the absorption of water and minerals present in the water from the soil. Okay, this is one of the functions by which this process helps the plant, that is absorption of water and also minerals which are dissolved in water. Those minerals will be also absorbed, and there will be upward movement because of this process, transpiration. Plants are not moving. So plants have to withstand all the climatic conditions, and temperature is regulated by this process, transpiration. In plants, soluble products of photosynthesis, they are transported by another tissue known as the phloem. And this transport of soluble products of photosynthesis in plants, this is called as the translocation. Phloem transport the soluble products of photosynthesis. This is one of the functions of phloem. So phloem also transport amino acids in plants. Phloem consists of sieve tubes and companion cells. How translocation takes place in phloem? So phloem, which is an example of tissue, this is involved in transport of soluble products of photosynthesis. So sucrose will be taken in by the phloem, or sucrose enters in the phloem by using ATP. So phloem uses ATP. ATP means, I repeat, phloem uses energy from ATP. ATP means adenosine triphosphate, and because of this sucrose enters in the phloem. At that time, osmotic pressure in the phloem tissue increases. So what phloem tissue will do? Phloem tissue will make use of the energy from the ATP, and this sucrose will take in, will be taken in by this phloem by using energy from ATP. Next, osmotic pressure of the phloem tissue increases. That will make this water to enter in the phloem tissue, and from this phloem tissue, this material can be transported to the other parts of the plant where it is required, maybe in stem, in roots. Okay. So transportation of some materials in phloem takes place by utilizing energy, whereas transportation in xylem takes place by physical process. For example, bird, which requires sugar in, say, spring season. Now spring season is the season between the winter season and summer season. So when bird grows, at that time this require sucrose, this requires sugar. Jenna bird development stage jar asta tya vela taka sugar jay padta. So this sugar can be transported from, say, roots, stem, which stores sugar, to this bird by phloem. Okay, so we have completed transportation in human beings, we have completed transportation in plants. These are some of the questions this is asterisk which represents here note. Instead of typing note, I have typed as asterisk. You can go through this slide. Again, you can go through these slides. Yes, we have completed transportation in human beings and also transportation in plants. Let us learn the last topic under this lesson, excretion. So at the beginning when we started this lesson, I have given you many examples of life processes, and we have covered nutrition, respiration, transportation. Now we are going to start with the excretion. Now excretion is the process of removal of harmful metabolic waste from our body. When I say metabolic waste, see, various processes takes place in our body, various reactions takes place in our body, and those reactions produces waste. So that waste is metabolic waste. And this process of removal of harmful metabolic waste from our body is called as the excretion. Let us study the excretory system in human beings. So this is the diagram that represents excretory system in human beings. This has four main parts. One is kidney, ureters, urinary bladder and urethra. Manushyak don kidney asat. So this is left kidney and right kidney. Don ureters asat. Ureters are tubes. Ureter, again ureter, and this is urinary bladder and urethra. Okay. Left renal artery. So what left renal artery will do? Or left renal artery carry blood in which waste is present? Nitrogenous waste like urea. And kidney removes nitrogenous waste from the blood. Two main functions performed by kidney. First is kidney removes nitrogenous waste from the blood. Examples of the nitrogenous waste are urea and uric acid. Kidney, it maintains, it regulates the amount of water in our body. So these are the functions performed by kidney. So left renal artery will carry blood which consists of urea that enters in this kidney, and kidney removes urea or nitrogenous waste from the blood. Left renal vein will carry the filtered blood in vena cava. As we can see here, vena cava is name of the vein. Aorta brings the blood to the kidney or blood in the kidney. Then left ureter. As I said earlier, that kidney removes nitrogenous waste from the blood. So whatever waste is removed, urine will be formed here. Okay. That urine will be transported by this ureters, and that urine will be transported in urinary bladder. Urinary bladder, it is made up of muscles, it is muscular, and it is under our nervous control. See, we can control the urge to urinate. Now what is the reason, why we can control the urge to urinate? Okay, because urinary bladder is muscular and it is under our nervous control, that is why. Or when the bladder is full, urine can be passed out through urethra. Now, just like we have balloon-like structures present in lungs known as alveoli, which provides the surface area for exchange of gases, same way there are filtration units present in kidney, and we call such filtration units as nephrons. There are many nephrons present in kidneys. So after some time we are going to study regarding the nephrons. But there is reason for formation of urine. So urine is formed to filter out waste from our body or from the blood. Yes, now we are going to study the filtration units present in kidney. We call them as nephrons. We are going to understand the structure of nephron. So nephron consists of two main parts, that is Bowman's capsule, cup shaped part, and tubes. One end of the tubule is connected to the Bowman's capsule. The other end of the tubule is connected to collecting duct. So this represents one nephron. There will be other nephrons, and they will also send urine here. So collecting duct will collect the urine. Now renal artery will bring blood in which urea is present, in which nitrogenous waste is present. When it reaches in the nephron, at that time filtration of blood will take place. When blood gets filtered, at that time in tubule something will act as filtrate. So when we filter anything, we'll get two things. One is filtrate and the other one is residue. So in this case, tubule will consist of filtrate. Now what that filtrate will contain? It will contain glucose, amino acids, salts, urea, water. So that filtrate will try to move in this direction and will try to enter in this collecting duct. But as we know that there is bundle of capillaries present here, and that is nothing but glomerulus. One end of the glomerulus is connected to this Bowman's capsule. The other end of the glomerulus is nothing but bundle of capillaries. The other end of the glomerulus circulate these tubules. Edge of tubules dista teka circulate korun asta capillaries. As filtrate passes through these tubules, some of the necessary things from this filtrate, some amount of glucose, amino acids, salts, okay, this will be reabsorbed by the capillaries which surround the tubules. Amount of reabsorption of water depends on two factors. One of the factors is how much excess water is present in our body, or how much water is present in our body, and how much dissolved waste there has to be excreted from our body. Kitle waste bhayar hodupak jay amcha shariratlyan. Ya don factor acher, based on these two factors, the amount of reabsorption of water depends. Okay, then whatever is left, it acts as a urine, and that urine will be collected here in the collecting duct, and this urine later on from the this is a part of kidney only, this is present in kidney, and from this urine will be passed to the urinary bladder by ureters, which are small tubes. Okay, we have learned that from this blood some of the substances will be removed. So this blood will become pure, and the pure blood will take this path. Okay, as I said earlier, the purpose of forming urine is to filter out waste from our body, normally from our blood or from our body. Normally two types of nitrogenous waste are removed, urea and uric acid. Okay, so we have completed regarding the excretion in human beings. Let us learn the next topic, that is excretion in plants. Plants also excrete waste. They also throw waste. During the process of photosynthesis, oxygen acts as waste product. So they give out oxygen through the stomatal pores. Plants also, they shed their leaves. So plants also store the waste products in the leaves that is going to fall. Plants also store waste in cellular vacuoles of the cell, or vacuoles present in the cell. We have learnt in 9th standard various cell organelles, and in vacuoles plants store their waste. Plants also excrete waste in the surrounding. Resin and gum, this also acts as waste, and this is stored in the old xylem tissue. With this we have completed this lesson, and there are some slides based on this topic. You can go through the slides. I take this opportunity to wish each and every student all the best in your exam. Study well, score good marks, at the same time try to become a very good human being. Thanks to Prudent also, and to the Goa Headmasters Association for giving me opportunity to present lesson. Thank you.